Sunaina was very happy today after doing the experiment on electricity in school. She was very eager to tell about this to everyone in home.
On reaching home, after washing her hands and mouth, she finished her lunch. She was eagerly waiting for her parents to return home from work.
As soon as mom and dad came back in the evening, Sunaina started telling them about her day.
Sohan also woke up after some time.
Mother, father, I wanted to tell you something.
Hey, Sunaina, let me sit first.
Sunaina and Sohan took the belongings from mother and father's hand and served them water.
Yes, Sunaina, now tell me, why are you so excited?
Dad, today at school we lighted a bulb with the help of batteries and wires.
Hey, wow, you must have enjoyed it a lot.
How did you do this, Sunaina Didi?
By making an electric circuit with the help of batteries and wires.
What is an electric circuit?
Sohan, to run any electrical device, an electric circuit is required, in which current flows. Bulb also lights because of this.
I also want to make electric circuit.
No, Sohan. Seema Didi guided us to make this at school. The material required to make it is not available at home.
Let me check in the old luggage box. I will surely find something in it. Sunaina and Sohan became very happy. Mother brought an old box. Father and mother picked out some old wire and a bulb from it. Sunaina took a cell out of the clock.
Oh wow, all the materials are collected at home only.
Sunaina quickly arranged all the materials in the same way as she did in the school. And the bulb lighted.
Oh wow, sister.
You know, all the electronic devices in our home run on this principle.
Didi, now how we will turn off the bulb?
By removing the wire from any one terminal of the cell.
But when we have to turn off a bulb in the house, we don't need to remove any wire.
Yes, it's a matter to think about as how the wires are connected to that button. The wires are placed inside the wall and we can't even see it.
Sunaina, if you want, you can put buttons in this electric circuit too to switch on and off the bulb. Such buttons are called electrical switches.
How is that, Father?
Let's try it now.
Dad cut the wire from one side in the circuit. Immediately, the bulb turned off because the flow of current stopped.
Sunaina, can you remove the plastic from these two ends of the wire?
Sunaina quickly removed the plastic layer. Dad took out a key from the old box and attached one end of the wire to that key.
Sunaina, now connect the second part of the key to the wire.
As soon as Sunaina connected the other end of the key to the wire, the bulb turned on.
Oh wow, it was very simple.
Dad, why did you use the keys to make the switch? There's a lot of stuff in this box.
Let's do one thing. Let's add different things to this power circuit and then check if the bulb lights or not. Mother picked up some items like rubber, iron nail, chalk, piece of cloth, piece of glass, etc. from the box.
Sunaina and I will make a list of all these things and see which things will light the bulb.
Sunaina made a list on paper.
First of all, let's try with this iron nail.
Sunaina removed the key and connected the iron nail. The bulb turned on.
Father, write yes in front of the iron nail in this list. Now let's try with eraser.
On connecting the bulb with rubber, it didn't light. Nor on connecting with the piece of cloth. But on connecting with the silver spoon, it lighted up. Iron nail, it lights the bulb on. Rubber, the light bulb doesn't turn on using rubber. Cloth, use of cloth doesn't light the bulb. Silver, silver turns the light bulb on.
Why is it that the bulb is illuminated by some things only?
That's because some of these things are electrical conductors and some are insulators.
What is it?
When the current flows in an electric circuit, if there is any resistance in between, the flow of electricity gets disrupted and the circuit is considered incomplete. Electric conductors are materials that do not stop the flow of electricity. Rather, these substances make the flow of electricity easy, such as materials made up of metals, iron, copper, silver, etc. That's why electrical wires are made up of metals, so that electricity can flow through them.
But plastic is there on the top of the wires, right?
Yes, wires made of metals are coated with insulating materials. Insulating materials are the substances that prevent the flow of electricity. This is done to prevent people from getting electric shock on touching the wires. So, this is very important.
Yes, children, you should be very careful with electricity. Such experiments should be done only in the presence of elders. Even in home, use electric devices only in front of elders. If carelessly handled, it can cause severe injuries.
Yes, Father, we will take care of these things.
Wow, I really enjoyed doing the experiment with you all.
Me too.
Us too.